Hi, I'm HC. For weekly videos on self-knowledge and self-discovery, like this video and hit the subscribe button. Here are 5 steps on how to have emotional control. Step 1. Check yourself first. In this context, to check yourself first implies making sure that you have dealt with your own internal issues before emotionally projecting inner woes upon circumstances in your life. Oftentimes, bottling up hurt from the past encourages pain, confusion, and misunderstanding in the future. Checking yourself implies being conscious of your own biases so that you can make sound decisions going forward, instead of acting and reacting to situations that may not even be what they appear to be. Always remember, in order to not react emotionally in the moment, the inner work has to be done prior to the incident. Think of this like having a car that's been making a weird sound, and instead of going to the garage and having it checked, you ignore the sound, which then results in your car breaking down when you least expect it. And now, you have to deal with the repercussions, despite you having so much time to prevent this issue prior. Check yourself by asking yourself, are there things that you are less comfortable with, and why? Are there situations that you always seem to or choose to avoid? What is leading to those choices? By confronting yourself first, you are preparing yourself to confront situations that may involve others going forward. This leads us to our next step. Step 2, mental dieting. The term mental diet was coined by author U.S. Anderson from his book The 3 Magic Words. Just like a food diet, where you abstain from certain foods in order to clear your system of toxins and other dietary matters, a mental diet implies abstaining from elements that influence your decision-making ability. This could be social media and online activity, but it can also be time away from certain friends and family and situations that tend to tug and tweak your perspective. Simply put, to practice a mental diet is to be conscious and selective of what you are consuming mentally so that you can have a better control over how you react to elements sent to disturb your peace. A mental diet is important when it comes to emotional intelligence because we often react emotionally without necessarily understanding why we are even reacting in such a way. A mental diet would encourage taking the time to process your emotions so that you can act and react accordingly going forward. Doing so encourages self-acknowledgement and promotes self-respect, which must always be stronger than your feelings. This makes you more conscious, purposeful, intentional, and capable of making the impression that you wish to make. Step 3, be mindful. To be mindful is to be conscious and aware of the elements in play which has you going through what you are going through. You can encourage mindfulness by asking yourself, why are you thinking the way you are thinking? And questioning what is involved in encouraging the situation at hand. By asking yourself these questions, you introduce a wider scope of understanding to your perspective, because now you are considering much more factors related to and leading up to the event where you feel emotionally triggered. Always remember, when you feel heated emotionally, it is usually a buildup of other factors that led up to that point. If you are feeding your mind with a limited perspective that has been mostly negative, when you are triggered, you are likely to lash out because many things have been leading up to that point. Think of this like filling up a jar with water. The jar has a rim and thus has a limit. And although you could take in much more water at a time before when the jar was empty, the more you fill the jar up, the closer you get to the rim, the more likely that even the smallest droplet of water that touches the glass will encourage the water spilling over. By being mindful, you are avoiding this reality because you are making yourself aware of the factors that hold an influence over your emotional state, and thus, you're likely to be able to act accordingly prior to that outpouring of emotions. Step 4, hold yourself accountable. Holding yourself accountable is an important element that supports emotional intelligence. To hold yourself accountable is to acknowledge and be responsible for how you feel. Always remember, although people and situations can influence your emotional state, you have all of the control. Meaning, if someone has control over your emotions, it is only because you gave it to them. Accountability will help with emotional control because once you accept your role in how you feel, you can make more informed decisions about who you spend your time with, what you spend your time on, and how you spend your time and energy at all. By being accountable, you can recognize when it is time to remove yourself from a situation, different from when it would be time to entertain a situation, thus helping you discern from moments that are likely to trigger you from those that will encourage your inner peace. Hold yourself accountable and grow forward. Finally, step 5, mind your language. Always remember, thoughts become things, and your words are the conduit to manifesting those things into the world that we all share. The way you speak of things plays a very important role on what they become in your world. Thus, speak with your emotions in accordance with them, rather than from your emotions. This encourages emotional intelligence because rather than being controlled by emotions, you are demonstrating that you can maintain your poise, all while expressing exactly what you mean. By speaking in accordance with your emotions, you are describing them and presenting them eloquently, according to the situation at hand. In contrast, when you are speaking from emotion, the message usually gets lost or melts and dissolves in the fire of raw emotions. Always remember, when you say what you say, even if you said it because you were hurt, you are creating and encouraging a reality according to that hurt. However, it is important to always be conscious of the truth that you can't take back what you speak. This is like trying to put back a shattered vase together. No matter how hard you try, the vase will never look just as it once did. So, mind your language and manifest your peace. Emotional control can be the difference between the construction and the destruction of meaningful relationships and situations in our lives. Because sometimes even when we care for someone or about a situation, it's hard to express your differences without coming off as disrespectful. And this is why knowing how to control your emotions is such an important factor on the journey of you becoming your best you. Thank you for watching this video until the end. You are appreciated. Like and share this video to a friend, and consider subscribing to this channel if you haven't already. I'll see you here next time on Howell Consultations, the how-to to being true to you.